Since 1983, archaeologists at the Museum of London have worked with societies in the region to ensure that the capital's abundance of historic sites are given every protection. Supporters say the department has been an outstanding success. Its work includes the restoration of the Elizabethan Rose Theatre and the preservation of these Roman baths at Huggin Hill. But the department's secure future was today questioned by four senior archaeologists. In a letter to the Times newspaper, they condemned changes they expect the Museum of London to announce tomorrow. They include cuts in staff, they say fewer new projects will be undertaken, and they allege decisions have been made without consultation. The letter has the support of London MPs.
Tomorrow, unless they change their mind, the board are going to end the comprehensive archaeological service in London. That's a breach of promise. When the GLC was abolished, we, the MPs, were told by ministers in committee that archaeology would be safe. The board is quietly seeking to change that.
If important sites come up in the immediate future, it is possible, I think, that they could be just disregarded and the evidence destroyed without record.
Managers at the Museum of London deny they're putting important sites at risk, but say some economies are inevitable.
There may be changes in the number of people that we employ for the reason that most archaeology is development funded, in other words, funded by developers when we do excavations, so they're on limited contracts.
The museum give no guarantee that jobs won't be lost. In a time of recession, they say the scale of privately funded research has to be questioned. But archaeologists say the loss of just one important site would be a tragedy for London's cultural history. Jonathan Ray, Thames News.